Hello friends, today we are going to discuss the brief introduction and working of Geiger-Müller counter, commonly known as GM counter. This counter was designed in 1928. So GM counter is one of the oldest detectors have been introduced by Geiger and Müller in the year 1928. So when the voltage applied to the gas field detector is increased beyond the proportional counter region, the pulse height does not remain proportional to the energy of the incident ionizing charged particle. The counter which operates in this region of higher voltage is known as GM counter, and the output pulse for the GM tube is high due to 10^9 to 10^11 pairs, and does not require any external amplification for the signal. So this is the interesting part of this counter. So principle, it works on the principle of the indirect ionization. So the indirect ionization means the electron produced in the active volume of the counter by passing the charged particle are accelerated under high potential difference, further produce ionization termed as primary, secondary and tertiary, and called the resultant ionization is called indirect ionization. So as a result of which avalanche production of electron ion pairs and which results in Geiger discharge, and which are collected by respective electrodes and produce a signal current, or that is current pulse. So it consists of basically three parts termed as GM tube, pulse counting circuit, regulated high voltage power supply. So this is the GM tube, which is encapsulated in a glass tube. So the internal part is in the GM tube, and then it is connected to the central wire. This is central wire, this is cathode, cylinder and anode wire. So when the charged particle passes through this counter, it creates the ion pairs along its path. So there is electron and positive ion pairs. So central wire, which is made up from tungsten W, and they are connected to the respective electrodes, and as a result it becomes a sensor of the charged particles, which are somewhat amplified and displayed on the digital display to the count. There is a number of charged particle passing through it. So the different parts, for example, the GM tube, it is a cylindrical copper tube, M of diameter 1.5 centimeter, and length 200 centimeter, depending on the purpose for which it is to be used. It is enclosed in another cylindrical glass tube G, and the tube contains a mixture of polyatomic gases such as argon and 10% vapors of ethyl alcohol at the pressure of 10 centimeter of mercury column. A fine tungsten wire of diameter 0.5 nanometer is stretched along the axis of the copper tube, and it is well insulated and sealed in the glass tube. The positive high tension is connected to the central wire, that is anode, through the resistance R, and negative terminal connected to the copper cylinder, which is termed as cathode. So pulse counting circuit, the electric pulse produced in the GM are fed to the pre-amplifier their scaler, and finally detected and counted by the counter. High voltage regulated power supply. It is required for the GM region and the pulse counting circuit. So working, consider an ionizing particle passing through the active volume in the GM tube. The condition for avalanche to start is that is E electric field at the center wire, and lambda is the mean free path. That is E into lambda is equal to V into lambda upon A log V upon A to the base E. So that is the ionization potential, where small a is the radius of the central wire, that is anode, B is the radius of the cathode, that is cylinder, lambda is the mean free path, and V is the applied voltage, that is the potential difference. The electrons having small mass are quickly collected by the anode, and the heavy positive ion move much more slowly towards the cathode, cylinder. So as a result of it, so immediate after the production of electrons have been collected by anode, but the positive ion has to travel the distance equal to the radius of the cylinder. So they produce a positive ion sheath around the axial wire. Now when the sheath is close to the anode, it decreases the potential around it below the GM region. So what do the meaning of sheath here is the closed tight covering around the anode. So because the sheath contains the positive potential, as a result the potential on the anode decreases. So no second avalanche is produced and the GM counter is inactive for that time. So when the positive ion sheath reaches to the away from the anode, it again recovers and start producing next avalanche. So as positive ion sheath moves slowly towards the cathode, so at the same time potential around the anode goes on increasing, and again the avalanche is produced, and the whole process is repeated again and again. So there are three parameters which are important for the GM counter, that is dead time, recovery time, and resolving time. So these parameters can be easily understood from this graph. So this graph contains long x-axis there is a time, and long y-axis this is a potential at anode. So this is the ionization current, and this is the applied voltage. So when we applied the voltage, start increasing the voltage at between anode and cathode of the GM tube, so this is the starting voltage of the GM region. When it is, we start increasing, it is almost proportional, and as a result it becomes constant, and this constant region is called plateau of the GM counter, and this voltage is termed as VO. VO is known as operating voltage, and it is in between approximately 30% away from this start of the plateau. This voltage is along y-axis here, and the time is along this direction. So this voltage is vary with time. When the positive ion sheath is there, the potential on the anode start decreasing, and when it is low below the VS, then below VS, not below VS, below V operating voltage, the GM counter does not respond to the next ionizing event. So as a result, the GM counter is dead for this time. So this time is called dead time. And after moving the positive ion sheath away from the anode, voltage or anode start increasing, and as a result now GM want to start working but not accurately, so that this time corresponding to this region is called recovery time. So the sum of the dead time and recovery time is called the resolving time. Okay, and from these three, dead time of the GM counter is approximately 200 microseconds. So dead time counting rate, the true counting rate can be calculated. So that is observed counting rate divided by 1 minus observed counting rate into dead time. So by knowing the dead time, we can calculate the true counting rate. So dead time loss, that means the number of charged particle that have crossed the GM tube without detecting. So that is known as the dead time loss. That is true counting rate minus observed counting rate. This is known as dead time loss. So efficiency of counting is defined as the ratio of the number of counts observed per unit time to the number of ionizing particle which pass through the counter during that time. So this is the ratio, and percentage efficiency can be calculated by multiplying it by 100. So this is all about GM counter. Thank you.